There are certain limitations of dimension analysis that I have written here. Let us discuss these one by one. This method, the first one is, this method gives us information about the dimension, no information about the dimensionless constants, for example pi, 1, 2, 3, so on, right? Since these are dimensionless constants, so while deriving the formula which includes such constants, we have no idea about that. We simply derived, let us talk about the first numerical in which we have derived, the time period. In that case, t directly proportional to the factors m raised to power a, l raised to power b and g raised to power c, right? And after removing this proportionality constant from here, what we get is k. Now, what is this k value? We cannot get from this method. So, this is one of the limitation of the derivation by dimension analysis or dimension analysis limitation. Second is, if a quantity depends on more than three factors, since we know that while calculating this, we are using the dimension formulas in terms of MLT and then compares the powers of MLT on left hand side and right hand side. Now, if any physical quantity contains the one more term, for example, if it includes current or any other term, in that case, temperature, in that case, that value will not be included in the formula, and hence we won't be able to get the proper formula. So this one is also one of the limitation. Next is, we can't derive formula containing trigonometric functions. If any formula contains factors containing sine, cosine, tangent or any other trigonometric functions, it does not give any idea about that, because theta is a dimensionless quantity. Theta is a dimensionless. And while writing, while comparing left hand side and right hand side, if theta factor is to be included, that is dimensionless, so we will not taken into consideration. So it is not able to derive the formula containing trigonometric functions. Next is, the method of dimensions cannot be used to derive any form of relation when it consists more than one term on any side. On any side, for example, if we talk about s is equal to ut plus half at square. Now, if we want to find out the relation of displacement with velocity and acceleration, so it will not be able, because if we talk about this is the distance and this is the distance, distance only added to distance, so we are not able to find out the exact form of relation. Or again, if we are talking about, if v square minus u square is equal to 2as, again these are the unit of v square and this is also the unit of v square. So it is not possible to find out v square minus u square to the left hand side or ut plus half at square to the right hand side. So this is one of the important limitation of the dimension analysis also. Next, last one is, it gives no information whether the physical quantity is a scalar or vector. What we calculate, we derive the formula, we check the correctness, we can convert from one system to another, but we are not able to find out whether this is a scalar quantity or a vector quantity. So these are the basic limitations of the dimension analysis.